Hey guys, welcome back to Crafting with Cardboard. I'm Mr. Waxman, and I'll be showing you how to make some fun easy crafts while we're all staying home. I brought something to show you guys today. Do you know what these are? These are face masks. You might see people wearing these in the street or at the store, and the reason is that when you wear a face mask, you cover your nose and your mouth and you keep your germs to yourself, which makes everyone a little bit safer. It's important to do your part to keep yourself and others happy and healthy, so that's why I've been wearing a mask. Now, there are lots of different kinds of masks, but I want to show you how this one works. Put the straps over my head, and then I take these straps and tie them around back, and then I've got a mask that covers my face and looks pretty cool. At least I think so. I'll take it off. Now, like I said, there are lots of different kinds of masks. I made these. This one I made with a sewing machine, and this one I sewed myself with my hands. So if someone in your family knows how to sew, they can make one for you kind of like this. Or you can just use a piece of fabric. You could wrap a t-shirt or a bandana or a scarf around your head. You could get the disposable kind if you can find them at the store. But basically, anything you can use to cover your mouth and your nose when you go outside is going to make a difference. They can be fun to decorate. You can use them to play ninja or other games, and you can get just as creative with your face mask as you can with any other project. Last time we made some fairy houses and found object color wheels. Here are some pictures that friends sent me of their awesome work. My cousin Tess in Vermont even made a color wheel using just pencils and markers, which I think is pretty cool. Because I've loved seeing the pictures of all your work, moving forward every Wednesday at noon, I'm going to be hosting a big open Zoom meeting, a big open online video chat, where you can log on, talk to me and everybody else, show off your artwork, and have a good time. So please look out for a link for that on the Encore homepage, and hopefully I'll see you next Wednesday. Today, we're going to be using our cardboard crafts to make a special kind of movie called a stop-motion animation. Stop-motion animation is a filmmaking process by which you can take regular objects and make them appear to move on screen. This is how movies like Wallace and Gromit, Coraline, and even parts of the Lego movie were made. Basically what you do is you take an object, take a picture of it, move it a little bit, take a picture of it, move it a little bit, take a picture of it, and you repeat this process many times until you have lots of photographs, and then when you play them back, like a really quick slideshow, kind of like that, the object appears to be moving on screen. So let's get started. For this project, you're going to need a background for your video. For mine, I just took two pieces of cardboard, glued them together, and put some paper over the top, but you can just use a wall and a table. Some objects to animate. You can use toys or your cardboard crafts or pretty much anything else. A phone or tablet and something to rest it against, preferably plugged in so you don't have to adjust it. And an app that you can download free on your phone or tablet called Stop Motion Studio. There are a few different stop motion animation applications you can download. Find the one that works best for you. This is just the one that I happen to be using, but they're all pretty much the same. Okay, so here is your basic setup for making your stop motion animation. I have my object, which I'm just gonna animate, which is just this little cardboard car, right on my background. I've got my phone with the app set up on this little stack of books, and I like cut this little toilet paper thing to make a little stand for it, because it's very important that the camera stays in the same position the entire time. And notice that I also have my phone, like I said before, plugged in, because if you have to stop to plug it in, you might move the camera a little bit, and that's going to change your video, because all of the pictures need to be taken from the same exact position. Okay, so I have the app pulled up right here. It's called Stop Motion Studio. I'm going to click New Movie, and then it's going to show me that I can add some pictures. So first, I'm going to get this in the position that I want. I'm going to try to make sure that I am only looking at a white background, or that I have the pretty much only the background in place. Okay, so you can see, or hopefully you can see in this picture, that you can't see the side of the table or the wall, just the background that I want. All right, so I'm gonna put my car here on the side, and it's going to, actually I'm not gonna put it in yet, I'm gonna have the car drive through by taking a bunch of pictures of it doing just that. Okay, so first I'm gonna click the little camera button, I'm gonna take a picture. I know you guys know how to do this. Okay, took one picture. Now I'm going to move the car ever so slightly into frame, meaning like into the shadow of the camera. I'm gonna put it here so that you can just see just the tip of it coming into the picture. Take another picture. A little bit more. Another picture. A little bit more. Another picture. Oh, just a little bit more. Another picture. A little bit more. Another picture. I'm gonna keep doing this until the car is all the way off the screen, and then you'll see what the video looks like after. All right, so now my car is all the way off the screen. In total, it looks like I took 17 pictures. You can take more if you want it to move a little bit slower, or less if you want it to move a little bit faster. But let's take a look at the video. I want to move this so you can see it in front of the camera. All right, here's the video. Let's play it back. Look at that. It really looks like the car is driving right across the screen, which is really cool. This is a very simple animation. This is a very simple kind of movie. You can make yours do whatever you want. I've got a little guy, I can make him walking and maybe getting in the car and driving off. This is really your opportunity to get as creative as you want and make whatever kind of movie you want. I just wanted to show you how the app works, but I'm sure that once you guys get the setup right and start taking pictures, then you'll come up with some great ideas of your own. Why don't we go visit Sam in the workshop and see what he's working on today. Hey, Sam.
David.
What you working on today?
So today I'm working on a table that I'm making out of plywood and some copper.
Ooh.
And this copper is actually from some old gutters that used to be on the house that we're in right now.
Oh, so that's right.
When we replaced the gutters, we put the old copper gutters under the house, and I hammered it flat into a clean sheet of metal.
Wow, that's really cool. So you didn't have to really buy any of this stuff, you just kind of found it around?
No, yep, it's all scrap wood and found copper.
Oh, that's cool. And do you like working with like materials that you're able to find, or do you prefer buying them at the store?
I actually really like working with materials that I can find around, just because it's fun to build projects around what you already have in the house.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's nice to be able to find a piece of material and design something around that.
Absolutely. And then the material kind of has its own kind of importance to the project, too.
Yeah,
like
so,
go ahead.
Yeah, different kinds of materials will dictate, you know, what kinds of projects you can do. So it's sort of nice to have to build a project around the restrictions of, you know, only using materials that you can find, or, you know, what you can do with those materials.
Yeah, it's like a challenge in and of itself, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Kind of like that table you made before with a rock in it.
Yeah.
I know that you use pretty much only things that you found around the house for that as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Great. Well, thanks.
No problem.
All right. Isn't it cool how Sam was able to use some materials that might otherwise be considered trash, like those copper gutters, to make a beautiful piece of artsy furniture like he is? When artists or makers of any kind recycle old materials to make something new, they are being what's called resourceful. And being resourceful is a really good quality to have as an artist, because it allows you to use the things that are around you, use the resources that you have to make something unique and cool, just like we are doing with our cardboard cities. Neat. Next, I'm going to show you guys how to make another kind of animation that requires no technology, just good old-fashioned paper and pens, flipbooks. For this project, you're going to need some paper or index cards. Index cards are a little bit better, but if you just get some paper and cut it into these card shapes, that works just fine. You can also use post-it notes instead. Some clips. You can use laundry clips like these, or binder clips, anything that's going to hold your paper together. Something to write with, and a window. A flip book is a kind of animation where you draw several different pictures on several different pieces of paper, and then when you stack them all up, you can flip them really fast and you'll see what looks like kind of like an animation or a cartoon. You may have seen something similar in the Captain Underpants books, or even like old cartoons are essentially made this way, where they do one drawing, take a picture, do another drawing, take a picture, and they just like flip through the pictures really fast. But this is just kind of a simpler, easier way to make a little animation. So what I'm gonna do first, I don't need to clip the pictures together just yet, so I'm gonna put these clips aside, and I'm going to start just by doing one drawing. You want to do it closer to the edge, meaning the side of it, because you're going to be holding it over here while you flip, so your drawing should be closer to the edge, okay? And I'm just going to do a little animation of a guy waving, okay? So I'm just going to draw a man, a little stick figure, keep it nice and simple, and there's his arm, okay? Now, here's where the window comes in. In my next drawing, I want the stick figure to look exactly the same. I want him to be in the same spot. The only thing that I'm going to change is this arm right here that is going to be waving. That's going to be the animation part. So to make sure that everything's in the right place and in the same size, I'm going to put my piece of paper on top of this. And then, as you can see, you can already see through it a little bit. You can kind of see it underneath. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold it up to the window instead. So that I can see it really well through the other side. If you look closely, see, now I can see this, the man, my little stick figure, right through, and I'm just going to do a few more drawings where they look, you know, trying to make it look exactly the same, except I'm gonna change that arm. Okay, and then I'm just gonna keep going. I can just keep, adding a new piece of paper on top of the previous drawing, okay? Make sure the edges are lined up so that it's in the same spot. And you're gonna wanna do a lot of these. They do not have to be perfect, just like with anything, as long as you're having fun and trying your best. That's really all that counts. Okay, I should have enough by now, so I'm going to make sure when I am gathering these up, just change the camera a little bit. I'm going to make sure when I'm gathering these up that I am collecting them by kind of dropping them all together against the table on both sides of where that my little character is, or wherever whatever your drawing is going to be, so that they're all in a nice straight line against the edges, you know, and it'll flip a little bit easier. Then I'm going to attach my clips. Binder clips, like I said, are a little bit better, and index cards are usually the best kind of paper you can use because it's a little bit thicker. But regular paper is fine so long as they're all cut to be mostly the same size. And then when I flip it, it should show. Oop. Sometimes I'm not great at flipping. All right, my friend Candace just pointed out to me that you don't want to hold the book flat like this when you're trying to flip it. You wanna turn it, bend it a little bit so that the previous pages are flipping away and you can see the new one, all right? So let's try that. Cool. So when you speed it up, and again, you're probably gonna wanna do a few more drawings than I did. I just kinda kept it to a few to keep the video quick. But as you play them, as you flip them along, it should look like the little guy is waving, and you can do an animation, a flipbook of anything. You could do a ball bouncing, or of like a flower growing, or of people dancing, or jumping, or something. But yeah, it's basically just a really simple, kind of easy, fun way to make a little, to make your own little cartoon at home without even having to use any kind of special technology. So yeah, that's a flipbook. Now, I'm going to show you another stop-motion animation I made a long time ago when I was a student. It's called Fireworks. I hope you enjoy. Thanks for joining me for another episode of Crafting with Cardboard. Remember to send me pictures or videos of any artwork you're doing, and try to join me for that Zoom call on Wednesdays at noon. That's 12 o'clock. See you next time. Bye.